Okay, good morning. So here we are observing about our lectures. As we have started the algae and for your semester first, the paper first 4101 plant systematics. So algae part we have started. So here today we are observing about the algal habitats. So in the algal habitats, as we are already knowing, algae commonly found in the water, and basically I have selected some other good examples are there. Suppose there is a seashore area is there, or there is in the ice areas are there, snow where the snowfall is maximum. So such area it is to be reported as the red snow, or it is commonly known as the watermelon. So like this one. So here you are observing the good photograph of this one, red snow and the snow algae, or there it is also known as the pink snow is there, or blood snow is there. The genus for generally this algal, it is unicellular form, our Chlamydomonas. So there is having the huge or tremendous development of this area due of this Chlamydomonas colonies are there. So it looks like the reddish in the color. Actually Chlamydomonas is a member of Chlorophyta, but at it shows there is having its appearance, it is like such red, pink, or the different this color. So you remember this is a good example. Then secondly, there is having this red snow. It is showing the appearance like this. The species is the Nivalis, Chlamydomonas Nivalis, right? So you remember this. Then nextly, there is having some green snow is there like this one. So here it also looks like the greenish in the nature or sometime, because it is member of also the Chlorophyta. You see the this non-motile cell is there, or generally it shows there is having the development of this. Then in this green snow, generally the Chloromonas, it is the one genus, species is the Chinia gonensis, Chloromonas tugiliensis. So all these reports are from the outside the Indian region. Then there are the certain one character about the symbionts or the endophytes are there. So what is meaning of symbionts? We are knowing there is having the beneficial to the both the parasite and the host. So generally symbionts generally in algae they grow on the other many plants are there. So some striking examples already we are knowing, the lichens, right? So they are in association with fungi. Then myxomycete members, Crucoccus, Nostoc, Microcystis, Cleocapsa. Then filamentous forms, Cytonema is there, Rivularia is there. So all these are generally in association with the lichens. Secondly, as some green algal members are there, the Coccomyxa, then Chlorella is there, Protococcus is there, Palmella is there. They also found along with that of the lichens are there. So these are the some specific habitats for the algae. Already we are knowing our rice fields are there, or the cycas plant is there. So in rice field they are in the form of the commonly seen the anabiana or some these members. So they play the role of fixation of atmospheric nitrogen, and it is to be used for the vegetative growth of the plants are there. So therefore these algae helps for the, suppose the good example in our pteridophytes, Azolla is there, Azolla genus. Here you are observing this photograph. So anabiana, it is filamentous with heterocyst and the generally having the green cells are green, chlorophyll is present. Actually it is there is having the cyanopycee member. So then other example in the cycas, coralloid roots are there. In cycles we are knowing some roots are above the ground or near to the surface of the soil. So generally they shows specifically these type of the algae are reported very nicely as the, about the nostoc. So in bryophyta, Anthoceros, then members of Anthocerotae, Notothylus, another genus. So from the lower surface, which is a ventral region attached to the soil region. So here the cysogenous, mucilaginous cavities are there. So nostoc trichomes or the filaments, they are commonly seen. In sphagnum moss also, nostoc colonies are there, because already we are knowing the sphagnum moss generally as it is separated from other mosses, and because due to the midrib is absent, so no venation pattern, but here the it having the water absorption and retention capacity. So and it is also a good anti septic properties there. So as nostoc is reported along with this one. Then secondly, there is a chlorotrichum. It is an endophytic algae. It is found in the certain aquatic angiosperms are there. Lemna, Ceratophyllum, or other mosses are there. So here you are observing some photographs of this, which are having the endophytes. Then endozoophytes are there. So in the body of the animals, suppose the Zooxanthella is the one algae. It is found inside the freshwater sponges are there. Or Zooxanthella, generally it is single celled. It is a dinoflagellate diatom, and which are able to live in the symbiosis with marine invertebrates such as corals, jellyfish, or the sea anemones are there. Right, so you are knowing about these animals. So remember the proper name of the genus Zooxanthella. Right, then nextly, this Zoochlorella, as it is found inside the Hydra Viridis. Already we are knowing Hydra plant, as the it is the Hydra animal. So generally, as here the you see the photograph of this one. So the Zoochlorella. Chlorella is the unicellular filamentous motile form is there. Then some are the parasites. So certainly some algal members are there. For example, Cephalorus virescens, which causes a disease on the tea in the Assam and in the neighboring area, and it is called as a red rust of tea, and it is generally due to the this algal infection. Right, so you remember this example, Cephalorus virescens. Right, so this is the good one. And lastly, there is a one type is there. It is called as the fluviatile algae are there. Fluviatile algae means these algae found rapidly in the flowing water. Yellowthrix is our good example in the mountainous region. Stygioclonium is there. Batrachospermum is there, where the total fresh water is there. But in the part of Dehradun or our Castle Rock or hilly regions, these Batrachospermum, Stygioclonium, these are reported. Then there may be certain temperature tolerance to the algae are also reported, 70 degrees Celsius or more than this. Certain equatorial areas are there. Some algae members of Oscillatoriaceae, they survive in the 85 degrees Celsius. So you may select the certain good project, anyone, about this one. Okay, how algae will be tolerating their life cycle. Right, so I think this is a good subject for the study. Okay, so this is about one lecture. I am also taking the another two lectures on the habitats, algal habitats. Okay, so have a nice day. Thanks.